For any of you guys that have done a lot of bead rolling, I'm sure you've come across this problem like we're showing right here. You have a nice flat panel, you lay all your beads out, you roll your beads perfectly straight, you think everything is great, you pull it out, and well, it's just like this. It's all warped and popping when you try to lay it into the vehicle. Now, a lot of guys I've seen, they tack weld it and they hammer it into submission and make it fit, but in the end, the fit and finish just isn't really that nice. Now, I have one here that we've already done, the same process, and it sits pretty darn flat. We don't have to force it into submission. This is done with a process called pre-stretching, which I'm going to show you on this other panel here. I've already laid out the beads, so we're ready to go. So let's walk over the English wheel and we'll show you the process. All right, so we have our panel in the English wheel here with basically no tension on it. I can slip it between the wheels. And what we're going to do is set the panel up. It's pretty much centered in the wheel. And we're going to put, I'd say, moderate tension on it. We want enough tension that we're actually moving some metal. So I got some moderate tension and I'm going to start rolling it. And we're going to focus on basically about an inch on either side of this line. This line is our center line of our bead. And we want to focus on stretching the metal right around that, maybe an inch on either side. So I'm going to roll this back and forth a handful of times, trying to basically just go right to my start and stop point and keep the rolls nice and tracking nice and tight, rather, like this. So we got these first two rolled. I'm going to finish rolling these last three, and then we're going to go over to the bead roller and we'll show you what we're going to do then. So as you can see, by just wheeling each of these bead lines a little bit on either side of the bead line, we have stretched the metal and given us extra material for the bead to then use up when we roll all these beads in the panel. There's a little bit of distortion in it now from using it in the English wheel, but once we throw these beads in here, it'll pretty much all flatten out and we won't have that crazy oil canning that we showed you on our test piece earlier. So let's throw it in the bead roller and we'll show you what it looks like. With the last beads rolled, we put the panel in the VersaBend and put two flanges on either side of the floor pan. As you can see, by pre-stretching before we rolled the beads, it left us with a pan that's almost perfectly flat. Now that we fit it in the car, you can see the finished product is very nice.